The Marcos administration held its first palace briefing a couple of minutes ago. Our very own Pia Gutierrez now joins us with details. Pia, over to you.
Hi, Carmina. Yes, Press Secretary Attorney Trixie Cruz Angeles held her first briefing here in Malacanang. And during the press conference, she clarified that President Ferdinand Marcos supports the creation of the Bulacan Airport City Special Economic Zone and Freeport. This despite Marcos's veto of House Bill 7575 last July 1, or the measure calling for its establishment. Malacanang noted the need for Congress to further sharpen the law and cure the defects of the measure, particularly the provision which exempts the Commission on Audit to look into the financial transactions on the economic zone. She said that there is a need for Congress also to clarify the procedures expropriating lands for agrarian reform beneficiaries, to clarify the needs and bounds of this economic zone, as well as a need for a justification from lawmakers that the zone will be nationally significant and will not narrow the country's tax base. She said that this veto to correct the defects is to prevent the constitutional challenges that are already expected later on, and that the establishment of the economic zone will be delayed further if the law is invalidated. Let's listen in to what Secretary Cruz Angeles said a while ago.
There is no indication of such certification, but the importance is evident in the explanation of the veto, that he merely wants these things to be sharpened. An approval of this law might result in a delay of its implementation because it might be challenged. So that's how important it is for him that a law is more finely crafted in relation to those matters that he has raised.
Also, Carmina, contrary to expectations, there were no announcements of new positions, particularly of the critical positions in government, such as the Secretary to the Department of Health. She said that the President is still strictly evaluating current candidates for the position, and that while he has not set any deadline for the appointments, she noted that these evaluations are already on the final stage and that she doesn't think that these appointments would be too long coming. And this is what the Secretary said about the matter.
Wala po sa binibigay sa amin na sinasabi nilang deadline. Ang sinasabi is masuri talaga ang pag-evaluate nila dito sa mga kandidato para sa mga posisyon. I understand that this is now going through the final evaluation stage. So, I don't think it will take too long. Ang sinasabi lang namin is dumadaan sa matinding pagsusuri. Wala tayong sinasabi nahihirapan or anything like that. But because these are important, precisely because these are very important positions, kailangan dumaan talaga sa butas ng karayom. We will rely on the President's wisdom to choose the best people for the job.
Meanwhile, the press secretary refused to answer questions regarding the birthday celebration of the former First Lady Imelda Marcos last Saturday, pictures and videos of which went viral on social media. Cruz Angeles said that she was not there, so she could not answer how the party went, but said that the concerns of the public on the supposed lavish celebrations making a comeback to Malacanang during the Marcos era are already noted. And she also insisted that the president will adhere to law as far as the social events in the palace are concerned. However, there is no policy yet, much like the previous Duterte administration had before, on how celebrations or social gatherings will be held or conducted in Malacanang. She also said that the president remains very upbeat and energetic during his first days in office. This morning, he attended the first flag raising ceremony in Malacanang, where he addressed employees of the office of the president. And Carmina, according to a transcript that we received of his short remarks during the flag raising ceremony, the president encouraged OP, or Office of the Presidential Staff, to go one or two steps beyond in performing their functions and duties to the people. The Malacanang still refuses to divulge, however, what the living arrangements of the first family will be because of the security reasons. This is despite an earlier interview of Ambassador Bayo Romualdez that the first family will be living in Bahay Pangarap. And overall, it was a very cordial and quick press briefing. There will be no regular press briefing yet. And she said that this conference that will happen in Malacañang will depend on whether there will be big issues to address by the Office of the President. Carmina?
Yes, Pia, they did release a statement. The Office of the Press Secretary did release a statement over the weekend saying that they will not comment, that they will only comment on matters of public welfare and public interest. So, and she reiterated that again during the press conference this morning. But the question is, Pia, if their office is not going to comment on such things, who will?
Actually, in her press conference a while ago, she clarified that the question that she answered was related on the billboard of the former First Lady appearing in Malacañang. She said that the press statement was related to that, and that because the billboard was neither funded by the government or it wasn't constructed by the government, and that it had nothing to do with any government policy, then the press secretary could not comment on those matters. But she did, however, say that as far as these concerns are concerns go, the palace or the Marcos administration will adhere to law as far as how celebrations or social gatherings will be held in Malacañang. So as far as that question goes, Carmina, she said that maybe if the question given to her is worded in a way that it does appear to concern public matters, then they will answer those questions, Carmina.
All right, we're going to have to leave it at that. Pia Gutierrez there joining us on the line. Thanks, Pia. Take care. Keep safe.